where someone was shouting about that. Church folk ain't never had more problem and they think God favored you more than them. Because they always think that you don't deserve it. Folk always think they deserve more than you. So the minute God starts favoring you, they got a problem and every problem's gonna be. And then next thing you know, you wonder, you mean Sister Mary said that? Yeah, Sister Mary said that, but she didn't say it to you. She was saying to somebody to make sure you get it right.
Amen.
It's a good season, man. Rejoice. Rejoice about life. It's time to be happy. Hey, God, happy. It's time to rid yourself of all that foolishness and all that negativity. It's time to be happy, man. Get those crazy people from around you. Who you gotta deal with, but don't listen, hear me. Don't entertain it. Don't respond. Oh, thank you, Lord. If God has somebody to respond before, he's gonna leave it to you. Found you faithful, man. He said, you didn't quit. You believed in the midst of it. You believed in the should have quit.
Glory
to God. And just the same way that you submitted to my will in the midst of the hell. I'm going to put you on Front Street now. And no man can tear down who God raised up. Bible says he raised one up and he tears one down. And he tear you down, nobody can't help you. And he raised you up, nobody can't stop you. That's why I wish you all again. Y'all need to get some attitude about being blessed. Don't be ashamed of your blessing, flaunt it. Because that devil tell you, man, you shouldn't say nothing, you know, because that may go away tomorrow. But let it go away tomorrow. I have it today. I'm going to boast of God today. Let me be close here because it's time for us to just rest in Jesus. Amen. This roller coaster running, y'all. Amen. Hear me what I'm telling you, it's running. And if you're on it, you're going to enjoy it.
Amen.
See, the only thing about that you have to be careful of, I can't see your spirit, God can.
Amen.
I ain't going to run, I might lose some offering if I go to that room. You see, I can't see your spirit. We can't you shout, we can't see your spirit. God knows what's going on in your heart.
Amen.
So it's this time for all of us to take a personal inventory. You know, God's been really good. I mean, I got a couple of people calling me from North Carolina today. And, you know, like I told you, God showed us tremendous, so much favor up there that the preacher's mad.
Wow.
I ain't saying nothing. I'm not going to go there. The preacher sent an email complaining about how we were treated. Y'all ain't ready for this kind of stuff. That's the kind of favor God will show you. You were the new kids in the block. They call me and say, man, you wouldn't believe they complain about why we treated you this way and then treat them that way. They've been around for all these years.
Favor.
Someone look at them and say, that's favor. Look at someone and say, that's favor.
Favor.
And you should expect favor when you walk in any environment. Expect me to get something to treat. Oh, young man, all the hell you done been through believing God, you will get upset when somebody show you favor. Rejoice in it. Show it off. The Lord has favored me. I'm just about done. Am I helping you here? What we gotta do right now is just trust in the finished work of God. I'm done. The works have already been finished. The tides have already turned. But when you shifted this new dimension of grace, you shifted another dimension of warfare.
Wow, that's it.
But you shifted with the power to deal with it.
Now
you're walking here. Because God wouldn't have shifted it unless he empowered you to do so. You remember all the times you were crying and desperate? He was empowering you. He was giving you all your ready for it. All the times you wanted to quit, he was empowering you. All the times you told yourself, I'm not going back to church, I can't stand the people, but you came back anyway. He was empowering you for where you're at right now. It was never about them, it was about you. The fact that you walked in and had your head up when you knew they were talking about you, he was empowering you. He was giving you boldness, you're ready for it right here. Because it's about you for where you're at right now. So that when you speak, it can affect the environment. I'm happy to be here.
Yes, sir.
He's already empowered you for the place you're at. And the most important person in this right now is you.
Yes.
Not
yes.
Them.
Yes.
You're going to get what you say.
Yes, God.
That's why it's so important to know what he promised you.
Yes, sir.
It's so important to know the promises in God's word.
Yes.
Because right now, the warfare is all about, remember a couple of weeks ago when we started talking about this dimension, what the enemy does, he shoots words.
Yes.
Spiritual words. They call them God. All your thoughts are numbered